If anyone would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by his infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in his presence to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at his hands, to declare his most worthy praise, to hear his holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for our sake, that we may now live a godly and righteous and sober life to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Alleluia, the Lord is risen indeed. O come, let us adore him. O be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, not we ourselves, we others. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and speak it of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. Alleluia, the Lord is risen indeed. O come, let us adore him. O God, the nations have come into your inheritance. They have defiled your holy temple and made Jerusalem a heap of stones. The dead bodies of your servants have they given to be meat for the birds of the air, and the flesh of your saints to the beasts of the land. Their blood have they shed like water on every side of Jerusalem, and there was no one to bury them. We have become a reproach to our enemies, an object of scorn and derision to those who are round about us. O Lord, how long will you be angry? Shall your jealousy burn like fire forever? Pour out your indignation upon the nations that have not known you, and upon the kingdoms that have not called upon your name. For they devoured Jacob and laid waste his dwelling place. Oh, remember not our past sins, but have mercy on us speedily, for we have come to great misery. Help us, O God of our salvation, for the glory of your name. O deliver us and forgive our sins for your name's sake. Why do the nations say, where now is your God? let the vengeance of your servants' blood that is shed be known in our sight among the nations. Oh, let the sorrowful sighing of the prisoners come before you according to the greatness of your power. Preserve those who are condemned to die. As for the blasphemy by which our neighbors have blasphemed you, repay them, O Lord, sevenfold into their bosoms, so we who are your people and the sheep of your pasture shall give you thanks forever, and will always be showing forth your praise from generation to generation. Hear, O shepherd of Israel, you that lead Joseph like a sheep, show yourself also, you that sit upon the cherubim before Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh. Stir up your strength and come to help us. Restore us again, O God, show the light of your countenance, and we shall be whole. O Lord God of hosts, how long will you be angry with your people that pray? You feed them with the bread of tears and give them plenteous tears to drink. You have made us the derision of our neighbors and our enemies. Laugh us to scorn. Restore us again, O God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be whole. You have brought a vine out of Egypt. You have cast out the nations and planted it. You made room for it, and when it had taken root, it filled the land. The hills were covered with the shadow of it, and the boughs thereof were like the mighty cedar trees. It stretched out its branches to the sea and its boughs to the river. Why have you broken down its hedge so that all those who go by pluck off its grapes? The wild boar out of the wood roots it up, and the wild beasts of the field devour it. Turn again, O God of hosts. Look down from heaven. Behold and visit this vine at the place of the vineyard that your right hand has planted, and the branch that you made so strong for yourself. As for those who burn it with fire and cut it down, let them perish at the rebuke of your countenance. Let your hand be upon the man of your right hand and upon the son of man, whom you made so strong for yourself. And so we will not turn back from you. Oh, let us live, and we shall call upon your name. Restore us again, O Lord God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be whole. O sing merrily unto God our strength. Make a cheerful noise unto the God of Jacob. Take the psalm, bring hither the timbrel, the merry harp with the lute, blow the trumpet at the new moon, even in the time appointed, and on our solemn feast day. For this was made a statute for Israel, and a law of the God of Jacob. This he laid upon Joseph for a testimony, when he came out of the land of Egypt. I eased his shoulder from the burden, and his hands were delivered from bearing the load. You called upon me in troubles, and I delivered you, and I answered you in the thundercloud, and tested you at the waters of strife. Hear, O my people, and I will admonish you, O Israel, if you will hearken unto me. There shall be no strange god among you, neither shall you worship any other god. I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt. Open your mouth wide, and I shall fill it. But my people would not hear my voice. But my people would not hear my voice, and Israel would not obey me. So I gave them up to the stubbornness of their hearts, and let them follow their own imaginations. Oh, that my people would have hearkened unto me, that Israel had walked in my ways. I would soon have put down their enemies, and turned my head against their adversaries. The haters of the Lord would humble themselves before him, and their time of punishment would endure forever. But Israel would I feed with the finest wheat flour, and with honey out of the stony rock would I satisfy him. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy, beginning with the 17th chapter, the first verse. You shall not sacrifice to the Lord your God an ox or a sheep which has a blemish or any defect, for that is a detestable thing to the Lord your God. If there is found in your midst in any of your towns, which the Lord your God is giving you, a man or a woman who does what is evil in the sight of the Lord your God by violating his covenant, and the person has gone and served other gods and worshipped them, or the sun or moon, or any other heavenly lights, which I commanded not to do, and if it is reported to you, and you have heard about it, then you shall investigate it, and you shall investigate thoroughly. And if it is true and the report is trustworthy, that this detestable thing has been done in Israel, then you are to bring out to your gates that man or woman who has done this evil deed, that is, the man or the woman, and you shall stone them to death. On the testimony of two witnesses or three witnesses, the condemned shall be put to death, and he shall not be put to death on the testimony of only one witness. The hands of the witnesses shall be first against him to put him to death, and afterward the hands of all the people, so you shall eliminate the evil from your midst. If a case is difficult for you to decide between one kind of homicide or another, between one kind of lawsuit or another, and between one kind of assault or another, that are cases of dispute in your courts, then you shall arise and go up to the place which the Lord your God chooses. So you shall come to the Levitical priests or the judge who is in the office in those days, and you shall inquire of them, and they will declare to you the verdict. Then you shall act in accordance with the terms of the verdict which they declare to you from the place which the Lord chooses, and you shall be careful to act in accordance with everything that they instruct you to do. In accordance with the terms of the law about which they instruct you, and in accordance with the verdict which they tell you, you shall act. You shall not turn aside from the word which they declare to you, to the right or the left. But the person who acts insolently by not listening to the priest who stands there to serve the Lord your God, nor to the judge, that person shall die. So you shall eliminate the evil from Israel. And all the people will hear and be afraid and will not act insolently again. When you enter the land which the Lord your God is giving you, and you take possession of it and live in it, and you say, I will appoint a king over me like all the nations who are around me, you shall in fact appoint a king over you, whom the Lord your God chooses. One from among your countrymen you shall appoint as king over yourselves. You may not put a foreigner over yourselves, anyone who is not your countryman. In any case, he is not to acquire many horses for himself, nor shall he make the people return to Egypt in order to acquire many horses, since the Lord has said to you, you shall never again return that way, and he shall not acquire many wives for himself, so that his heart does not turn away, nor shall he greatly increase silver or gold for himself. Now it shall come about, when he sits on the throne of his kingdom, that he shall write for himself a copy of this law on a scroll in the presence of the Levitical priests, and it shall be with him, and he shall read it all the days of his life, so that he will learn to fear the Lord his God. By carefully following all the words of this law and these statutes, so that his heart will not be haughty toward his countrymen, and that he will not turn away from the commandment to the right or to the left, so that he and his sons may live long in his kingdom in the midst of Israel. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke, beginning with the 9th chapter, the 18th verse. And it happened that while he was praying alone, the disciples were with him, and he questioned them, saying, Who do the people say that I am? They answered and said, John the Baptist, and others say, Elijah, but others that one of the prophets of old has risen. And he said to them, But who do you say that I am? And Peter answered and said, The Christ of God. But he warned them and instructed them not to tell this to anyone, saying, The Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected by the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed and be raised on the third day. And he was saying to them all, If anyone wants to come after me, he must deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me. For whoever wants to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake, this is the one who will save it. For what good does it do a person if he gains the whole world, but loses or forfeits himself? For whoever is ashamed of me and my words, the Son of Man will be ashamed of him when he comes in his glory, and the glory of the Father and the holy angels. But I say to you truthfully, there are some of those standing here who will not taste death until they see the kingdom of God. About 8 days after these sayings, he took along Peter, John, and James, and went to the mountain to pray. And while he was praying, the appearance of his face became different, and his clothing became white and gleaming. And behold, two men were talking with him, and they were Moses and Elijah, who, appearing in glory, were speaking of his departure, which he was about to accomplish at Jerusalem. Now, Peter and his companions had been overcome with sleep, but when they were fully awake, they saw his glory and the two men who were standing with him. And as these two men were leaving him, Peter said to Jesus, Master, It is good that we are here, and let's make these, and let's make three tabernacles, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah, not realizing what he was saying. But while he was saying this, a cloud formed and began to overshadow them, and they were afraid as they entered the cloud. And then a voice came from the cloud saying, "This is my son, my chosen one. Listen to him." And when the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone, and they kept silent and reported to no one in those days any of the things which they had seen. On the next day, when they came down from the mountain, a large crowd met him, and a man from the crowd shouted, saying, "Teacher, I beg you to look at my son, because he is my only son." And a spirit seizes him, and he suddenly screams, and it throws him into a convulsion with foaming at the mouth, and only with difficulty does it leave him, mauling him as it leaves. And I begged your disciples to cast it out, and they could not. Jesus answered and said, "You unbelieving and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you and put up with you? Bring your son here." Now while he was still approaching, the demon slammed him to the ground and threw him into a convulsion. But Jesus rebuked the unclean spirit and healed the boy and gave him back to his father. And they were all amazed at the greatness of God. But while everyone was astonished at all that he was doing, he said to his disciples, "As for you, let these words sink into your ears. For the Son of Man is going to be handed over to men." But they did not understand the statement, and it was concealed from them so that they would not comprehend it. And they were afraid to ask him about this statement. Now an argument started among them as to which of them might be the greatest. But Jesus, knowing that what they were thinking in their hearts, took a child and had him stand by his side. And he said to them, "Whoever receives this child in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives him who sent me. For the one who is least among you, for the one who is least among all of you, this is the one who is great." John answered and said, "Master, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow along with us." But Jesus said to him, "Do not hinder him, for the one who is not against you is for you." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you created everything that is, and by your will they were created to have their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain, for with your blood you have redeemed for God from every family, language, people, and nation a kingdom of priests to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lamb, we worship and praise, dominion and splendor, forever and forevermore. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy. Lord have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, whose Son, Jesus Christ, is in his earthly life, shared our toil and hallowed our labor. Be present with your people where they work. Make those who carry on the industries and commerce of this land responsive to your will. And give us all a right satisfaction in what we do, and a just return for our labor. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as surpass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love towards you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises which exceed all that we can desire, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, Almighty God, you gave your servants, the martyrs of Sudan, boldness to confess the name of our Savior Jesus Christ before the rulers of this world, and courage to die for this faith. Grant that we may always be ready to give a reason for the hope that is in us, and to suffer gladly for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you as eternal life and to serve you as perfect freedom, defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries. Through the might of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hardwood of the cross that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit, that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, and above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, Alleluia. Glory to God, His power working in us can do infinitely more than what we can ask or imagine. Glory to Him from generation to generation, in the church, and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever.